Welcome to the Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracle's RPA Center of Excellence.
Hello everyone, I'm Praveen Kumar Gogla, working as a lead researcher for cloud and RPA teams. In this video, I would like to talk about how to automatically maintain the cases or the issues that are raised within the Salesforce application using UiPath. Here is our agenda for today. At first, I'll be talking about what are robots and the business use case overview and the reference architecture flow, followed by a live demo. RPA technology is sometimes called a software robot or a bot, which mimics human work. With RPA, we can automate desktop, web, and Citrix environments. It logs into applications, entering data, calculating, and completing the task, and then it logs out from the mission without human interaction. Top applications where RPA includes customer service, accounting, financial services, healthcare, human resource, and supply chain management. RPA can be used for procurement, automating order processing and payments, monitoring inventory levels and tracking shipments. RPA technology can help organizations on their digital transformation journey by enabling better customer service, allowing processes to be completed much more rapidly. It also creates cost saving for manual and repetitive tasks, which enables employees to be more productive. Here is the business use case overview. Two things we need to consider here. One is from the customer side, and the second one is from the vendor side. Customer relationship portal is built on the Salesforce, and the customers can raise the ticket related to the product issues within the CRM application. And every ticket that has been raised by the customers will be having a sales order ID, and the item name, and the date of purchase, and so on. Sometimes more than one product can be sold under one sales order ID. And the SPO number is not mandatory while logging the issues into the CRM application. On the vendor side, there will be having an internal web application and where the product related information can be found within the database, and that information can be retrieved using the internal web application which is on-premises. For every ticket within the Salesforce, a representative at the vendor cross-checks the sales order ID. By using the sales order ID, he is going to get the product related information from the application. If the SPO number is not provided by the customer, then they are going to cross-check by using the customer's email ID and the date of purchase of the product. Once the information is retrieved from the internal web application, by using that information, warranty is calculated, and then a report is generated for the specific issue or that for that specific ticket, and then the same report will be uploaded onto the Salesforce portal. Moving on to the next slide, we are having reference architecture flow. At first, the created bot will be logging into the dataloader.io portal and exports the issues into the CSV file. Now the CSV file is read for each individual ticket. So for each issue, the bot is going to extract the email and as well as the sales order field. So these email and the sales order field will be passed to the internal web application which we are having on-premises. By using this email and the sales order ID, the bot is going to retrieve the information from the web application which is related to that particular product. So once the information is displayed on the web application, the bot will be scraping that information, and then it is going to calculate the warranty duration, and then it will be generating the reports. So in that way, it will do it for all the records, for all the issues within the CSV file. So once it is done, the bot again logs into the Salesforce portal and reopens the individual cases or the issues and attaches respective reports based on the case number in both PDF and document format. After attaching all the reports, it will log out from the portal. And let us start with the live demo. This is the template that we have used for generating the report. Here is the automation flow that we have built to run this entire process. So let me run this automation. At first, it is logging into the dataloader.io portal. Now it is passing on the credentials by fetching it from the Windows Credential Manager. Now it is exporting the cases or the issues that they have raised today. Now these tickets will be downloaded into our local folder in the form of CSV file. can see this at the bottom, case export. Now it is asking us to select the file which contains the cases information. Now it is passing the first information, the first ticket information. Then it is generating the document, report. So here the bot is generating both in document as well as PDF format report. Now it is generating the PDF format. So now the second ticket information is passed on to the web application. The information is fetched. Now it is generating the report for the second information, for the second ticket. And for the second record also, it generates both doc and PDF format reports. Once it is done, it is logging into the Salesforce portal in the same way by fetching the information from the Windows Credential Manager. As we only have two records inside it, so it runs twice. So it passed on the case number. Now it is exported. Now it is attaching the PDF, doc and PDF format report to that specific issue. Now the second case number is fixed. Yes, it is found. Now it is attaching the respective reports as well. Now it is log out from the Salesforce application. Once it is done, it log out from the Salesforce portal as well. And then it stops, the execution stops. With this being said, the demo is completed. Thank you.
Thank you for watching The Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracles RPA Command Center. For more about automation, please visit miraclesoft.com/RPA.